हेलो डियर स्टूडेंट्स, लेट अस स्टार्ट आवर डिस्कशन अबाउट मैग्नेटाइजेशन एंड मैग्नेटिक इंटेंसिटी। एज वी नो दैट इफ वी पुट सम फेरोमैग्नेटिक सबस्टांस और पैरामैग्नेटिक सबस्टांस इन अ सॉलिड वायर, देन दैट टाइप ऑफ सबस्टांस कैन गेट अप अ सम प्रॉपर्टी दैट इज नोन एज मैग्नेटाइजेशन। एंड how we can define this magnetization numerically? So as we know that the magnetic dipole moment possessed per unit volume by any magnetic substance is known as magnetization. Suppose that we have any type of magnetic material and total volume of the magnetic material is V, and the total net dipole moment possessed by the total volume V is M, then the magnetization possessed by that magnetic substance can be defined as the total net dipole moment M net divided by volume. It means the net magnetic dipole moment possessed by any magnetic substance per unit volume is defined as the magnetization. It can be represented by a special symbol that is known as M, capital M, and M net is the total magnetic dipole moment. V is the volume. As we know that the unit of this magnetic moment is ampere meter square, and the unit of this volume is meter cube. So the unit of M is equal to ampere meter square divided by meter cube. So this is the ampere meter square divided by meter cube. This becomes ampere per meter. Ampere per meter. Okay. So this is a particular unit of the magnetization. Now similarly, we can easily derive what will be the dimensional formula of M. So from here we get that the unit of the magnetization is ampere per meter. So ampere, that is A, and per meter, that is L power minus 1. This can be written as L power minus 1 A. This is the dimensional formula of the magnetization. Okay. So this is the magnetization possessed by any magnetic substance, and this can be defined as the total net magnetic dipole moment possessed by per unit volume of the substance. It can be represented by capital M, and its unit is ampere per meter, and dimension is L power minus 1 A. Now let us come to a particular physical quantity that is known as magnetic intensity. For this, suppose that we have a solenoid, and this solenoid contains N turn. Total number of turn is N, and the total length of the solenoid is L. So per unit length, total number N can be defined as N by L. This is the number density of the solenoid. Okay. So if there are small N turn present in per unit length, then what will be the amount of the magnetic field intensity at any point inside the solenoid if the current flowing through the wire is taken as I? If the current flowing through the wire is considered as I, then what will be the value of the magnetic field intensity just inside the solenoid? So this can be assumed as B inside is equal to mu 0 n I. Okay. So we use this formula. Suppose that this magnetic field is without placing any type of magnetic substance inside the solenoid. So this magnetic field can be considered as B naught. So this is the magnetic field intensity produced inside the solenoid due to the current flowing through the wires wounding upon the solenoid. Okay. So the total magnetic field intensity produced inside the solenoid can be represented by a symbol B naught, that will be equal to mu 0 n I. So let us discuss what will happen when there is a magnetic materials or magnetic substance placed just inside the solenoid, then what will be the effect on the magnetic field intensity inside the solenoid? And also, without placing any magnetic substance inside the solenoid, if the current flowing through the wire is I and the number density per unit length is N, then what will be the magnetic intensity inside the solenoid? In this case, if there is no any magnetic substance, then the magnetic intensity in the solenoid can be defined by a particular term H, that is represented by equal to N dot I, H equal to Ni. This is a particular term then can be defined as the magnetic intensity, and the unit of this N is per meter, because N, small n, can be defined as capital N divided by L. N is the total number of turns present on the solenoid, and L is the length of the solenoid. So unit of this L, N, is equal to N by L, that is turn per meter. So turn per meter, that is per meter. If we write the unit of this H, then we again find that the unit of H is same as the unit of this M, that is magnetization, and this will be equal to ampere per meter. Okay, so from here we are seeing that the magnetic intensity and magnetization have the same dimensional formula, also the same unit, but magnetic intensity can be represented by a particular formula, H equal to Ni, and the magnetization can be represented by the formula M net, that is total magnetic dipole moment possessed by the magnetic substance divided by the volume of the substance, that is total magnetic dipole moment per unit volume. So let us discuss what will happen when there is a magnetic substance placed just inside the solenoid. Okay, so let us start. So suppose that there is a solenoid whose number density is small n, then the magnetic field inside the solenoid due to the current flowing through the solenoid is what? This is a particular, suppose that this is a solenoid and this is the wounding of the wires that flows the current over the solenoid, throughout the solenoid. So if the value of the current is I, then the magnetic field intensity at any point, that can be represented by B equal to mu 0 n I. Okay, and intensity at any point inside the solenoid will be equal to n I. So from here we can write at this it as B equal to mu 0, and if we put the value of n I as h, then we get mu 0 h. Okay, this is the second formula, B not equal to mu 0 h. Now, as we know that if we place a particular magnetic substance inside the solenoid, then what will happen? Then the magnetic field intensity inside the solenoid increases. Then the magnetic field intensity at any point increases, because when this intensity increases, then the magnetic dipole moment of the substance increases per unit volume. It means magnetization increases. So as we know that if we increase the external current flowing through the wire, it means the intensity, magnetic intensity H, increases, then the magnetic field inside any point also increases, because the magnetization produced inside the substance, that will also help to increase the magnetic field inside the solenoid. So if we place a particular magnetic substance whose magnetization is M, then total magnetic field at any point inside the solenoid can be defined as the magnetic field produced due to the current flowing through the wire plus the magnetic field produced due to the magnetization inside the solenoid. Okay, so this is the magnetic field produced due to the magnetization produced in the magnetic substance placed inside the solenoid. So this is the external factor which increases the magnetic field inside the solenoid, and this one is the internal factor. It means the magnetization produced inside the solenoid enhances the magnetic field. So this is the magnetic field which increases the magnetization inside the magnetization of the substance, or by that magnetization there is a magnetic field. So total magnetic field can be defined as B equal to mu 0 B 0 plus B m. So if we write this B m as we know that this B m is equal to what? Because B is directly proportional to m. As we know that magnetization increases, the magnetic field is also increases. So this magnetic field due to magnetization can be defined a particular term, Bm equal to mu 0 m. This is a particular formula for the intense magnetic field inside the solenoid due to the magnetization produced in the magnetic substance. Okay, so Bm equal to mu 0 m. So if we place these two value of B naught and Bm in this equation, that is equation number third, suppose that this one is the third and this one is the fourth. So if we place the value of B naught and Bm from second and fourth in the third, then we get B is equal to mu 0 H plus mu 0 M. So from here, if we take the common mu 0 from both term, then we get H plus M. So from here, we get B divided by mu naught equal to H plus M. So from here, we also again can define the magnetic intensity, that will be equal to B divided by mu naught minus of M. So this is the formula for the magnetic intensity in terms of the total magnetic field produced in any point inside the solenoid and the magnetization produced inside the magnetic substance placed inside the solenoid. So this is the particular popular formula for the magnetic field intensity, which relates the magnetization and the total magnetic field. Okay, so again, if we plot a graph between H and M, then we find that H is the external factor, that is the magnetic intensity produced at any point inside the solenoid, because we know that if we increases the current flowing through the wire, then the magnetic field intensity, at any point inside the solenoid increases continuously. Okay, so magnetization produced in the magnetic substance placed inside the solenoid is also increases. It means we observe that M is directly proportional to H. It means when we increases the magnetic field intensity, then the magnetization produced inside the substance increases. So if we remove the proportionality sign at here, then we get a proportionality constant that is known as magnetic susceptibility. This is equal to M equal to xi m h. Okay, here xi m is a dimensionless physical quantity that is known as magnetic susceptibility. Magnetic susceptibility. This is a dimensionless physical quantity. Dimensionless physical quantity. Okay. And the value of the xi m is measured for different substances, and it will obtain that the xi m is very small and positive for the paramagnetic substance, for paramagnetic substance xi m is small and positive, small but positive, and for diamagnetic substance xi m is small but negative. Okay, so this is a particular property for the xi m. From here we find that m is equal to xi m plus h. So if we put this value of m in this equation, so from here we get a particular value for b. So b can be defined as what? B is equal to mu 0 h, that is h equal to h, and this m can be defined as xi m h. So from here, if we take h common from bottom, then we get mu 0 1 plus xi m whole into h. So from here we get b equal to mu 0 and 1 plus xi m, that is known as what? Mu r. Why this is known as mu r? Because as we know that from here b naught is directly proportional to intensity. So if the total magnetic field present inside any point is h, then this b is also proportional to that h, and the total magnetic permeability of the medium or the substance placed inside the solenoid. So B can be written as mu of h. So from here, this is a similar formula for as the second formula. So if we write this as the formula number 7, so you are getting that mu equal to mu naught mu r, where mu r is the relative permeability of the medium or the magnetic substance. So this is equal to mu naught what? 1 plus xi m. This is a particular formula. Now from here you get that this mu r is equal to 1 plus xi m. This mu r is equal to 1 plus xi m. So as you know that 1 is the constant and dimensionless. Xi m is also constant and dimensionless, as we earlier mentioned that here. And from here we are saying that the mu r is the sum of the 1 plus xi m. So mu r is also dimensionless and constant. Okay, so if xi m is constant for any type of magnetic substance, then 1 is also constant. So mu r is also constant for any given substance. So from here we can easily find out what will be the value of the magnetic substance, what will be the value of the mu r for para and ferro. We can easily derive if we get the value of xi m for any magnetic substance. So we can also derive what will be the relative permeability of the magnetic substance with the help of this formula. Okay, so you can also categorize different types of substances in para and dia. The example of the diamagnetic substance is nitrogen, lead, diamond, and silver, and also bismuth, copper. These are the diamagnetic substance. And the example of the paramagnetic substance, aluminium, calcium, magnesium, niobium, chromium, etc. These are platinum. These are the examples of the paramagnetic substances. As we know that the value of the xi m is small but negative for the diamagnetic and small but positive for the ferromagnetic. So from here, if we get the value of mu r for the 1 plus xi m, as we get the formula mu r equal to 1 plus xi m. So we can easily find out what will be the value of the mu r. So mu r is small but greater than 0 for the diamagnetic. So mu r is greater than 0 but very small, less than 1. Okay, so this is the value of the mu r, that is relative permeability for the diamagnetic substance. And for para is greater than 1 but a small instant increases from the 1, that is 1 plus epsilon naught. Okay, this is the value of mu r for the, and if this is very larger in comparison to 1, so this becomes ferromagnetic substance. So in our next lecture, we describe what is the para, ferro and dia on the basis of the electronic structure. Okay, so this will be discussed in our next lecture. Till now, take care. Thank you.